It's the last 2 days, it's just been reflecting off of you. Again, my friend Josh pointed out that before we walked out, this will be the last show of the Gigaton Tour, the longest tour we've ever done. Of course, we couldn't play for the first year and a half of that tour. And we're finally making it back to places that we didn't get to play, and you were one of them. So thanks for your patience. I will tell you, for the future, if I'm getting a sense that you might like our group a little bit, but we just, I think, you know, we've made a record for next year.
Give me the
I don't want to give anything away, but what I can tell you is if you like the musicians in this group, I think you're going to hear them playing it. It just came out really good. You're going to hear them playing at their highest level. It's a really good collection. Sounds about saving the world, changing the world, might as well start in Texas. Thank you. Particularly for the front three rows. But he's added so much to our family and our group and being on the road together, and he's a great friend and great musician. Josh Klingon for everybody. And you all met Mike McCready, you know him. And everybody knows Sloan Dawson. Big Kahuna, the Hawaiian Islands, the great Mr. Boom, Gaspar! You call him the sheriff, El Jefe. He's got the low end up here. We can go high because he can go low. Mr. Jeff, the mighty, Amen. And not just the engine, but the driver. One of the greatest drummers on the planet in this world. This song's about habits, bad habits, but hopefully you got some good ones too. Actually, just give me 1 second to learn this. Seconds to learn.
Yeah.
Let me do a little singing on this one. I still got a lot of songs to do. I don't want to lose it on this one. And travelers, wherever you're from, would you give a big hand for my guy Simon right here? He's a great Irishman. And one more hand for the five Irishmen that served the night off. Let's hear it one more time for him. Hey. Trying to figure out what to play and thinking about, no, I already figured out I don't need your help. But maybe in like 20 minutes I might need your help. Or 45 minutes, I'm not going to help. Okay, in an hour I'll definitely be able to hear you. It's the last night of the tour. In 1 hour and a half, I'm going to be singing up a bottle of Irish whiskey. Let me say something you probably already know, or you probably know that I know. But if you have a microphone and you have a crowd gathered like this, not only are you grateful, but you're responsible. And we never want to say anything to divide people. But that's what I'm thinking about, wanting to talk about, is division, because we might be biased, because when we get out of Seattle and into the world and even around the world, we see people that are united and are all getting along and having a great relationship with each other and met each other through the moment and have had kids and friends and I'm going to talk more about that later, an hour from now. But I'm going to think that I should have said something about about division and how it just doesn't need to be this way. And if we're aware of it, we can fight it. And what we're fighting for is actually to be united. And how to be the United States and not the divided states. It's just so exhausting keeping up with the issues of like one or two white men. Just, it's too much. Their shit is too much, and they need to like keep it away from us and let us live our lives and be positive people to our communities, relate to our neighbor, relate to people of all colors and other genders and all colors and all genders, and be united. Next week, and remember that inquiry got a great response, and it will leave me with hope. And I thank you. And anybody, I'll say it like this: anybody who believes in anti and I was going to say anti-racism. Unification. Let's light up this room like candles. It'll be nice for the song. It's a prayer. Let's go to church.
Yeah.
But those lessons I never learned. And you know, Chloe does the table and the friends got her. Before we start this next one, is there a woman named Monica? Did she make it to the show? That's you. Hey. In Dallas, I reached in the crowd and she gave me this incredible book. I didn't know what was going to be in it. You know, sometimes it's a little scary opening a homemade book. I'm glad I took the challenge because it's just filled with incredible stories and beautiful stories of her hearing the band when she in 95 when she was 15, or 96 when she was 15. And the journey begins, and you know, she's from Poland, so she didn't, you know, she waited for us to come there. I mean, she was young, she couldn't just be traveling around by herself. And then she grew into meeting friends, which became family, and then and this is these people here. The power and the pictures of all you together, waited in line like 3 days before the damn show. You know, it's almost impossible to put it into words, so I apologize for, you know, I wish you could, I want it to have ultimate value, but you know, we really care about the people that come and travel, and it makes this work harder, I think. And we really try to make everybody happy in songs, and it blows our minds, and the best part is knowing that you all get along and have an experience, and really the music is just an excuse to be out in the world and traveling and hanging out together. And dancing. And We appreciate the support and any of the pressure you put on us, we're glad to take on. We love you and we'll miss you till next time. And Monica, it's a beautiful book. And in the end, by the end, she's had two incredible kids. She's got a great job, a really great life. And it started as just a 15-year-old who happened to hear a couple songs. Thanks for being out here.
She lies and says she's in love.
Nice to see you, man.
So we got Neil Young.
Take care. Until next time.
Sounds better than when I play it.
Nah, you did a good job.